In last week's tool tip, we discussed what happens or what is the effect of a tool with runout. Now this week, we will discuss what happens when the tool has no runout or minimal runout. So no runout creates even chip loads due to even contact on the workpiece. So as you can see from here, the grinding axis and the center line of the tool axis is exactly the same. So that means there is no runout, the cutting diameter or the flutes contact evenly on the workpiece, which means, you know, even wear, etc., on the cutting edges. So as a result here, you get even same load and have equal wear on all flutes. So this is optimal for end mills during machining. So tools have a better tool life or longer tool life. They're balanced and less prone to breaking, and you get a better surface finish and accurate finish parts. Now, what are the different types of runout? So it's every toolmaker's dream, you know, to have a tool or the first tool and the last tool in the batch to have minimum TIR. That is actually an advantage for better overall tool life and surface finish. Now, there are two kinds of runout, which is radial and axial. Now, radial is when the tool is actually running in the same axis but radially offset, whereas axial runout is, you know, when the tool is running not at the center line of the axis of the headstock, but it's got a wobbly effect. So these are the main tool types of runout. In next week's tool tip, we'll show you how to compensate for the axial runout while regrinding mainly, and the axial and the radial runout, which is the total runout compensation while manufacturing cutting tools.